Hi, and welcome back to our open Stopmotion film project. I was kind of forgetting myself. I was preparing for the kids' stuff on Monday, so
hi.
Forgot to look at the watch. So, but now we are ready for this. Yesterday we made a lot of put a lot of trees together. You can see here there's bad light and so on over there, but you can see something we have done over time. There's a lot of figures and we have a lot of besides what you see on the picture, we have lots and lots of these clay objects we have made, birds and a foot and a hand and a beaver and whatnot. We have tons of stuff we need. And I also managed to get the printer working today. At least we're getting some trees out of it. And that's kind of a good thing too, because the last couple of days we haven't been able to make any stuff at all with that. So, but this time it works. So, and why that's because this art. Okay. We are very high in CPU usage, so I don't hope that keep on. But we shouldn't have anything up and running except from goes down a little. I'm always nervous when it goes up too much, but I think we are. We are in the good part. You can probably hear, I'm getting my lunch now too, because I hadn't had the time. But, I said then we will make this one and then put it over there, and then we'll make some other ones. Yeah. That looks different, so we can get more printed, a more different kind printed, so we don't keep on behind here. We have there are only two kinds there. You can see in the background there are one kind more. We have printed three kinds of tree, but we need some more because we need a lot of trees, and we don't want to kind of do the same over and over again, so that you can see it when we make the film, that all the trees are identical. We don't want that. So this one we have made for kind of a long time ago, but it had, in the summer warmth, it had tilted a lot of times and get dented and whatnot. So we will make it nice again, and then we will get it scanned so they don't have to be kept that long in this state, because it's nearly impossible to avoid sometimes to push them more, so they tumble over. It's also like that the clay kind of shrinking a little bit over time, especially when it stands on the table like this too, then the table are sucking oil out of the clay, and then kind of squinks. And I have an owl behind the monitor who have tilted over a lot of time too, and I've got a flat face. That we have to restore also. So it's best to, and they are ready to scan, and I have made them, then I have to make them ready to scan, and then to get them scanned. Because the files are not getting corrupted like these are. Little fragile. it's all right, like. When I do this sometime, I think next day I will do the boring work, but I never get time for it because then the printer will not work, or then I have to make preparation for other things. And there are only 24 hours in the day. And yesterday I was around town buying stuff, and today it was a printer and preparation for Monday and so on. Start something new, like the kids' workshop. You always have. It always take a little time before you get it into a routine. What to do when, and so on. And we all know that at least the teachers out there know that you have to be really good prepared when you want to keep kids' attention. It's a little difficult too, because there is so many stages in a kid's life. In some periods they like something, and the other periods they absolutely don't like that anymore. So you need to for a short period of time in my life I was art teacher in a school, and that's kind of my profession, be dealing with as a graphic designer. So I just met up and thought I was ready, but I very basket wise. You cannot just meet up and wing it. And that was what I thought. If you're not in front of them all times, then they may fast get in front of you. All parents know that too, by the way, so. It's some kind of serious stuff. But fun. Giving, if you can get along with them, I had a lot of kids coming and going in our home, both my own children's friends, but also kids just come and visiting me because I have been working from home many, many years. And have been making what kids saw as fun stuff. I've had many good small friends. Impatient, but good friend. Some of the what is the word for that? Find that word. But it had been really enjoyable and really funny. these small episodes you always will remember. One day, a little friend, Thomas, came over and knocked on the door, and I opened, and outside he stood and with an Irish wolfhound, the world's biggest hound, dog, Irish wolf dog. It's a really big dog. Kind dog, but a big dog. And the dog was much, much bigger than he was. And but he looked at me and he said, "I should not be afraid because he had it in a leash." Lots of those small moments. Some of them I have even, I know still, and sometimes it's fun to hear what their experience was of it all. As far as I know, they liked it as much as I did. Our little friendship. Can get good friend with children if you respect them. And children are really smart. Just not so good at expressing. Themselves as grown-ups are, but they are exactly as smart as we are, and even smarter. So if you think back on when you were a child yourself, you pretty much saw the world as you see today, more or less. I know you have gotten more experience and so on, but people you didn't like then, you probably don't like today. Then you maybe not, you did not have that exactly why you didn't, but you knew there was something about them that you didn't like. Very honest. With what they think. Not that they want to hurt anybody, but that's just how they see things. They haven't learned yet to package it up. And just say it as it is, as they see it. Now I have grandchildren. And they have been on vacation and comes home tomorrow. That's a good thing. it's a long time while your kids are, your own kids are moved from home. And you kind of missing having kids around. Feel like it's over, kind of. But then, if you're lucky enough, grandkids arrives. And then it's really good. Sometimes even better than with your own kids, because you don't have the responsibility. You can just enjoy it. And spoil them. Kind of. Without thinking of the consequences. Not totally, but I'm sure you know what I mean. The parents have to do the hard work. You can just take the fun work, the fun part. And I am definitely up for that. But I do look after them when they are sick and so on, because then they can come and visit me when they are not allowed to go to school, because and we can't hang out here together. Computers, so nowadays that's a good thing. When kids, they can play Minecraft and so on. And when they are at home, in the daily life, there of course are rules for how many hours they are allowed to spend on TV and game. And then when we visit Grandpa, then there are no rules. All rules are our little secret. But of course they tell us as soon as they get home what we have done. They cannot keep a secret yet. They are not old enough to do that. So what the parents know. When you are sick or not that well, then you are out too. To do a little extra. Stuff you usually don't is allowed to do. So there is I think the printer is finished. Will it print now? Isn't that right? Yep. Then we have to wait a little. No, we haven't. It's not that. I will go over and put on a new.
Don't.
Sorry, it took so long, but as you see, and you see how hairy this is, and I really, the print is fine, but I do not understand why all of this. And I don't know if it's, this is the first plastic that had made that hairy stuff. And it seems like it don't matter what temperature that was what I was trying over there with different temperatures and then kind of stretch it. But and you can see down here, not that much, but as soon as you get up here, it gets really wild. See? Down here, there's nothing. But here, it's easy to remove, but I would like to understand why. Because I don't. Now I have lowered the temperature. But I don't know. I have to see how much plastic there is back on the road. I have done tons of print and never had that problem, but this is also a new and more expensive, but should be better plastic. And it's very stretchable when you take it off. Maybe that's a reason. Maybe I should do something else.
Just a minute.
I will wait until it has the first layer finished, then I will turn the temperature. We have to make a little trial and error. Maybe the extruder still have a problem. Very soon I have printed over a year with it without any of that kind of nonsense. So why now? I need the whole weekend to go and play with it. At least it prints. How much more can you expect? Get another extruder head. Maybe. But we don't give up that easily. That's the wrong mouse. Oops. Kind of seems when you are down here first, then you're close to the heat in the bed and you are there's more mass down here, so it's hotter, but the I don't know. And then we the blower starts, the fan starts. But I also can see some points where it's kind of not melting together. So maybe that. I have used a lot of time on that. I would take a cup and some oil. Thank you. so it's easier to dip. And then quest that was. Now we need some take it with us. Does it stick that good to cover? have to take a little peek. It's only layer 2. Something in here. Thank you. So I don't sail away in oil. Yes, what is it? Uh-oh. Maybe this can. Yes. Thank you. I think we can say finish with that. Maybe at first I just had to see if the fan was started. Maybe it first do that after the next layer. I think the guy on the net, he's broken to you. So we can see what he's doing. All the time. There's not enough strength in it. And now I had to see something on here. Because this tree I will bend a little. Like this, but these sticks are too thick, so I'll find something that is not so thick. Size for that, and they are stable enough to So greetings. Maybe we should go crazy and do like this. And put a little longer in up here. This was this one is pretty much. Can we pass it with this one or? Oh, we need
something bigger.
So we can't. Then we don't have to glue. If we glue like this. Now we will not. Go anywhere. And then, of course, I remove the. I have this here. And I will take a. It's also because the printer have gotten the software that runs the printer are totally new. I updated. I shouldn't have done that. I did. So why? I cannot get myself situated. Oopsie. Move the oil over here. See? Now we're gonna get one where it's a little crooked. Maybe we should go like this so we get a little distance. See what we are doing. We can. It's grown to the. Of the plate. And as always, when we start, we use a lot more than necessary so that we can have some kind of stability. Yeah. can always take it off. What a nice to work with. It together so we don't have a lot of air pockets in there. That will hunt us later on. And we need some thread. We can make some branches. Or maybe you're not. It's not as thick as it was last time. This. Maybe we should squeeze that also. Let's keep this one out here. Now nobody is turning out. Oil on my finger, so it's a little difficult to draw in this. But we got it. We got it. Because it's not always that nature makes straight lines, I guess. Even they seek the light. Something could have happened in its life that threw it on a little discourse. Yes. And that's what we are going for. Alternative route, could call it. I think the fan is prime. Experiment didn't end well. It always went wrong. When I lowered the temperature but just a little. So now we will turn it up. But have to start over. So I will have to do something. Thank you.
Now we will see. When it gets hot.
Because it's, we will see here what temperature is up at. It's because they have changed the software and default start is 200 with a set to, and I use more than that, and then to the first layer was 200 and to the next 200 too, but that's not gonna work. We have tried that, but then it changed automatically while we are sitting here. Maybe the extruder are not that efficient as it used to be, so that the inner temperature in the extruder are not the same as the outer temperature, because I cannot get it. I cannot get it cleaned good enough, because it's very small hole. I can only get a cover down to it. That's what I have that matches the best. I don't understand why, when they are making new software, then they go in and make change your setup when they update. That is totally crazy. If I wirecast my video mixer, if they update, they immediately load your, they only up,
their own stuff, and then they load your settings in the new part. But these guys here, they update, and then they change the setup, and that's not a good idea, because you have tweaked that setup over a long time to fit your needs and the stuff you're printing to get it as good as possible. And then they say they are new update, and you are a happy little camper, because that means it will get even better. But no, now you have to start all over again. And I have tried to load my old setup, but I cannot. I have that file. That's an any file, but it still uses their default. So that's kind of that I'm not that happy about, because now I have used a lot of time and a lot of plastic and a lot of everything to, and I still haven't got anything printed. And that's, yes, I have this here hairy one print, but and that's okay, but that's need a lot of after work. It takes a long time when the bed has to be that hot too. And the reason I want the head so, the bed so hot is that I get shift in the layers when I mount the clamps. You can see I get a shift like this, and that's a very, very difficult to avoid. You can see I have a shift there in the layer. And that's a little difficult to avoid, because when I set the clamp down, I of course pressure the bed a little. So, and when we are talking that small tolerances, then that does a lot. I think I need a better power supply, because it's a really trouble to getting up there with that small one. But and I have one laying around. I just have to mount it. Here's a little pony wiring on the power supply, so I don't know if I can use the one I have. We will see. Thank you.
She.
So. You only at 210 degrees. I'm sorry for pouring with that printer stuff, but I need to get it running. That's kind of a part of that stop motion one stop two. At least the way and path I have chosen. There is, of course, other ways to do it, but this is what I chose. And it's first today that we can see if it would it was worth it to do in this way. Worthwhile. That we, of course, don't know yet. So we see. Here we are. That's the best it can. Thank you. I have just said, so it should start at 230 degrees in the config software, but no. So it stops and waits to the temperature falls to 200. And then I go and control if I haven't set it. Yes, I have. Still don't. So I have manually to set it to 230 degrees. But often it is so with the software here, you have two shut it all down and start it all up again before it's load even the stuff it says it has saved in the any file. So sometimes you can get really fed up with it. A film. I cannot see from here where I'm, but it's gonna be a film. And what I'm making is a stop motion movie, and what I'm making is the part that is, or the stuff that will be a part of the stop motion movie. And it's about the Stone Age and two boys living in the Stone Age, and they are living in the wood. The main character Flint is living in a cave with his parents and grandparents and sister, and his friends are living by the lake, and they are fishermen, and Flint's parents are hunters. So, and I guess from that you can imagine the landscape, the lakes and the river and so on. But most of all, a big wood, a forest, or what you call it. I have to live it. So you can imagine, we have to make a lot of trees. And a lot of other stuff, but you can see, oops, over here, you can see some of the stuff, and much more we already have made, figures and whatnot, but there's a lot more around. Oh, I want a coffee. Now I can see it from here. I have to stand up. It's because laptop, I can see the chat room in over behind me. So because I need room to make stuff. and we, you can see here, where is that here, you can see a big tree, but some of it have to be close-up, we need to have some big stuff to do. And these small trees are more fill and kind of panoramic. And then I model them and then I print them. But I cut them in two pieces like this. So and I take them apart and then I put some wood in between and then I make them taller. Because I cannot print those big objects at once. So that's the reason. I don't know if you still are there or you're gone, because I was over by the printer. But I am always happy to ask questions, because I can understand that. Can be a little weird what I'm sitting here and doing. No more crew.
Feel that clean.
But there are places where we can get some of that. So if we take two, then we should have two the most of the night. Tilted. Does it? I have to see.
As always, the first layers are always good. That don't say anything about what to come. It always a little soft when you just have applied it. Thin stick we have in the middle. Not that it will break, but it's kind of very easy to the lesser surface it has, the easier it is. It is going to, well, maybe we can make a little trick here. And stuff.
and then we can let it cool down for a moment. We drink a little coffee. And keep our hands off it. That's the hard part. Can very well be that the extruder are not that efficiency to transfer the heat to the plastic as it once were. As we saw before, I cleaned it and I was up on 270 degrees and I couldn't even melt the plastic. So, and it was 270 degrees, but not inside the tube. So, and where will we? That it is so. The problem is to get something inside that tube. To kind of hone it. The plastic is, I don't know what I think that's exactly what the hole is 1.75 millimeters. So, I need to have something to put through with that size and that I'm able to scratch it off or something, because I don't think you can resolve it with anything absorbed. or what you call it. I think if you put acetone down in the tube, I don't think that will help, because it's kind of burnt. If I had a drill a bit that long and exact that measurement, I could do it. But I don't, and I don't know where to get it. I will try to figure out. As possible. Now I will go over and turn it up to 240. And we'll see if that helps. Thank you.
Well, I guess everybody is ready for weekend. Unused, brand new weekend. Where we can catch up on things. Time for a little quality time with the kids. Younger generation, a little party going. That is always fun. All my photo friends, if they have time at all, will go out and shoot all the beautiful fall colors. Yeah.
Oops.
I hit a tree. To brand someone. Thank you.
I keep doing that. Sorry. You get Sonic of having your arms up there all the time.
see anything from here.
I will go over and take a look.
Until now, it's working.
So, let's hope it keeps on doing that. Let us hope. I also have to remember I have a woodpecker lying in the fridge, and I have some mushrooms, and what are they called? Oyster hats.
it's best to get them out of there so I don't keep forget I have put them there. I think I have to pull together all the stuff I need to have, make marks on and scan. Break them all down again, and I have the pile. And build even more stuff. Thick up, yeah. Little less can do it.
It's getting a little soft. Well, I guess I have applied a lot of heat to it. With all my massaging around on it. Don't make it cooler. At all. Just take it's already gone sour. I do not understand why it paint the first layer, the first 4 or 5 layer perfect, and when, but cut this one out today. But my god, it's messy. And not nice. I know what I shall do this weekend. Figure out printer. I simply don't understand. Why is there? A lot of time. And I'm shooting in blind. Mm-hmm.
Yeah. Once again, we have reached midnight and it's weekend. And I will stop for today and start fixing printer. If I can, I will say thanks for watching, and I will hope I'll see you again Monday. And Monday we also have the kids workshop, and I will hope you will follow the kids, your kids, watching that, so you can help them. They need a little help with what we are doing. So thank you and good night from here.